What's up, Squirtle Squad? Sean here, and welcome back to another episode of Splatoon. In the last episode, we did some stuff and things, and now we're gonna do more stuff and things. Because, yeah. Where is the next level? And that is the question. Question of the day, where is the next level? Put the answer in the comments, and if you can get it. I don't even remember, that's how good I am. Okay, so we need to find 7. Where is 7? Where is 7? There is. The fact that they are invisible does not help in finding them. Nope, that's 9. Well, at least now I know where 9 is. There it is. I feel like I found 7 earlier. I don't remember where it is. I feel like that's what this situation is. Okay, looks a lot like my own skate park. Very, very reminiscent of the skate park. Where's the next level? There we go, okay. Level 7. Spreader Splatfest. Wait, Splatfest? Super Sea Snail? Ink stains and teardrops. What do we get? Super Sea Snails, guys, it's Splatfest! Oh boy. Oh boy. Festive, I will give it that. Very festive. Splitting to navigate scrolls. Okay. Alright, well, I know where it is. Splitting to navigate in the air. I bet you didn't know how good at games I was. Zapfish get. I forgot what those were called for a second. It's all good now. Repeat. All seven. The ink spray during a turf war vanishes almost immediately after the battle ends. How environmentally friendly and incredibly convenient. So, it doesn't have a chance? It just cleans itself? It's incredible. It's amazing. I don't know what how that even goes. I'm stuttering. Probably because it's been forever since I've been here. Anyways, level 8. Octoling Invasion. Help Dome showed up. Help Dome is a map, I should say, in Splatoon. It's not my favorite map. It's pretty big, as you can see here. But now we're on. We have company, Bucko Inc. Octolings ahead. Okay. Hey, this is my. Yeah, this is my turf now. Yeah. So that was fun. Wait, I didn't get the scroll. I'm a failure. I have to replay the level. Gosh dang it. At least I know all the ins and outs of this. At least I know like all the ins and outs of this one. Probably off to be the path. To play as the Octolings very easily, and so it led many people to theorize that maybe you'll be able to play as the Octolings in as DLC at some point, which would be very awesome. But we have a scroll to read, so Paradise Lost by Octolangelo. Well, that's a nice little apparently the Octolings have a pretty rich culture for. Used to be, it doesn't seem so. Anyways, unidentified flying object. Trouble over Inkopolis. Wait, I thought this was under Inkopolis. You tell me to go over Inkopolis? Hey, this is the, game that's like the tutorial level. That's an optimal shortcut. That was an oh, yeah, that is an instrument. Instrument is very dangerous. So, well, apparently that guy can just launch instruments whenever he feels like. So that thing was kind of broken. That's why I'm strike. Can you just not? Can you just not? With these ink strikes? Very annoying that you keep ink striking. Not so easy. And now he turns. Pink strikes are making my pink So is it? I think this is the boss now. I think the boss is up next. Seems that the Octarians can assume humanoid forms. These specimens have superior physical capabilities and are highly aggressive. High-ranking individuals have kelp on their heads. But what motivates them, if anything at all? The clock ticking. Now I can fight the boss. But before I do that, I'm going to upgrade my gear, and I'll upgrade Hero Shop, and I'll upgrade the Splat Bombs. I don't really use the Splat Bombs much. Maybe I should use them more. Anyways, excuse me. Fight and it's boss time. Stop the fight boss. Yeah. Shun the sneeze. The dreaded nozzle. Reminds me of the nozzle nose. It's not really like that weapon. But it's boss time. There's a net. There's like a net around this. Pretty cool. Anyways. Thank you. I died. I died. I died, but we got to see a few things. Fish get. Yeah! Shooting sneeze, octo nozzle, yeah! We did it! Scratchy scratch, wait, scratchy scratch. What's that sound? Cuttlefish. Busted radio. Must've broke. Wait, that's not supposed to. Buster radio must have broken. I keep losing his voice. You're doing great, Agent 3. Don't let up. I keep changing his voice, whatever. Anyway, we got the scroll, Anti-Octopus Weapon Blueprints Designer. And Moses Schellendorf, MR9's Booyah Base, if Incopolis, Lenishwan. I believe that is the Kelp Splatter Scope. Or not Splatter Scope, Splatter Shot. I believe that's what that is. Maybe it is a Splatter Scope, I don't know. I'm pretty sure that's what that is. Anyways, we beat the boss, and now we can progress on forward. It feels good. But hey, was that going to wrap up this episode? Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, like the video, I forgot to say that in the last episode. But whatever. If you enjoyed this video and you enjoyed that video, why don't you like them both? That'd be really nice. And subscribe to more videos. And with that being said, thank you all for watching. And goodbye.